Hello, I'm Aaron Parness. I work at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory, and I lead the Extreme Environment Robots Group. We're building the next generation of planetary rovers, and we take them out into places like the Grand Canyon, caves, Hawaii, and we test them in the extreme environments on Earth as a kind of practice before we send them off to other planets. I was always interested in math and science when I was in school, and I majored in mechanical engineering, and I did my undergraduate at MIT, and I did a PhD at Stanford, where I started to work on climbing robots. I think the most interesting job I had, I took a summer and was a ski bum in New Zealand. I washed pots and pans in the kitchen for about $6 an hour, but it came with a free ski pass. That didn't teach me much about how to build robots, but it was a heck of a good time. I'd advise middle school students to get involved, not only in their classes, but in clubs and side projects. One of my favorite things when I was in middle school was Odyssey of the Mind, and today there's Vex Robotics, there's Science Club. All of those kinds of activities where you're actually building things and getting real world experience, I would say do as much of that as you can. I've had a lot of great teachers along the way, including my mother, who is a high school English teacher. I think, you know, great teachers can really cause you to veer one way or another. And it was in college that I had a great robotics class that I think really set the course of my career. This was the 2007 course. It's kind of famous at MIT. And Professor Slocum taught that course to me. And we got to build robots and fight them against the other robots that the other students had made. It was a really transformative experience. Communicating well is something you don't appreciate when you're in school. But once you get into the workforce, you realize so much of your job is making sure that your ideas, your designs are understood by your colleagues. And in my work, I'm writing a lot of proposals. So being a good writer has been incredibly useful. It helps me win those proposals and get to do all the cool projects I'm interested in. Inspiration is all around us. If you look in the natural world, there are so many things that animals can do, that plants can do, that are really breathtaking. So how geckos climb walls, how whales are so hydrodynamic, their fins are much more efficient than even our best turbines. This is so incredible, and I'm always looking at nature and sort of asking, how do they do that? Failure is a critical part of being a good engineer. We practice something called iterative design, meaning that we're always making a new version of the robot. And until your robot's broken, until it's failed, you haven't learned all the lessons that you can from that design. So we expect failure and we embrace it as long as we're understanding why and how that failure happened.